الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلما فصل تالوت بالجنود قال إن الله مبتليكم بنهر فمن شرب منه فليس مني ومن لم يطعمه فإنه مني إلا من اغترف غرفة بيده فشربوا منه إلا قليلا منهم. فلما جاوزه هو والذين آمنوا معه قالوا لا طاقة لنا اليوم بجالوت وجنوده. قال الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقوا الله كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة كثيرة بإذن الله والله مع الصابرين. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. فلما فصل تالوت بالجنود، when تالوت عليه الصلاة والسلام went forth with his army, جنود with his armies, قال ان الله مبتليكم بنهر. He said to his people, Allah is going to test you with a river. The river Jordan, now it's very important, everybody knows it. This was in between and they crossed river Jordan. فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. Whosoever will drink from that river, he is not from me. He is not our companion. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي. And whosoever doesn't drink from the water of that river, he is from me, he is my companion. إِلَّا مَنِ اغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ. Except those who scoop a handful with their own hands. Take some water in the hand, in the hollow of the hand and take it. That is only permissible, but not drinking. فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُ. All of them merely drank from the water of the river, except only a few from themselves. فَلَمَّا جَعْبَدَهُ هُوَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. When they had crossed the river himself, that is Hazrat Talut, and people who believed with him, قَالُوا, they said, لَا تَاقَتَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَعْلُوتَ بَجُنُودِهِ. They said, we don't have the strength today to face Goliath, Goliath or Goliath, Jalut, Vajunudahi and his armies. They are very strong. They were scared. قَالَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمُ لَاقُوا اللَّهِ. Those people from among them who had the conviction that they will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day, they said to them, كَمْ مِنْ فِيَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِيَةٍ كَسِيرَةٍ. How often a small party has overcome a large party by Allah's leave, by Allah's permission. وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And Allah is with those who show patience and perseverance. Now please try to understand the background. Why the people were put to this test? Actually, before any confrontation, before any armed conflict, the commander of the army must know the condition of the people, of the army, of the soldiers, their morale, their discipline, listening and obeying. These things also, they mean a lot. Not only physical number, physical strength, not only the arms, but the state of morale of the people. And then you know the discipline. But if a command is given, if order is given, whether it is obeyed or not, whether the people have necessary self-control or not. So that was a test to which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through his appointed king, he put this army to test. And most of them failed. We have the example in the consultation with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He held that meeting of consultation before Badr also. He put a question, we shall read in Surah Al-Anfal. But now there is a caravan coming from the north with lot of wealth, merchandise. And an army is coming from the south. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised that He will give us victory over one of them. Which way should we proceed? Why this question? The same purpose, to see the morale of the people. Some of them said we should go towards the caravan because the booty will be great, we shall have great wealth, and you know only a few guards are there with the caravan. It will be easy to kill them, to round them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended something else. He wanted that there should be a direct confrontation between the Quraysh and the Muslims. So this is actually the example. But most of the people at that consultation, they said, O Prophet, what you have in your mind, you proceed in that direction. Why are you asking us? You have to make the decision. Which way you go, we are with you. So that is actually the same thing is happening here. Before this, this is the battle of Badr of the former Muslim Ummah. Please keep this point in mind. وَلَمَّا بَرَزُوا لَجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ And when they lined against the armies of Jalut, they said, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا وَصَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ Now they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching the Muslim, now you pray this. This is the prayer being taught to you before Badr. You must learn the prayer. رَبَّنَا أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا O our Lord, pour out perseverance on us. وَصَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا Make our feet firm. وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ And help us against this nation, these people who are kuffar, who are unbelieving. فَحَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ They routed them with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ And Dawood killed Jalut. There is a long story. Dawood was not in the army of Jalut, of Talut. He was a shepherd with his, you know, flock of sheep, etc. But he incidentally came at the scene of that battle, what was happening. And he saw that from this army of Talut, nobody is taking the courage to go and confront Jalut. He was calling, send someone who can fight me. That was the usual method of battles in those days. Personal wrestling, personal combat. But nobody dared going forward. Then Hazrat Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam, he himself volunteered him and he killed Jalut. And that way Dawood became important. And Saul or Talut gave him his daughter in marriage, and he became closely related to Talut, and then after Talut he became the king, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the prophethood and the knowledge and the wisdom also. So he had the physical strength, as much physical strength as he could dare confront Jalut and kill Jalut. فَحَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ In the same way, in the battle of Ahzab, there is one very brave person, and he was from the Kuffar, Amr ibn Abd Wadd, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he killed him. Otherwise, it was said about him that nobody can confront him, Abd Wadd. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala came forward, and he killed him and slayed him. فَحَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ وَآتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Dawood the kingdom, with wisdom, وَعَلَّمَهُ بِمَّا يَشَاءُ And He taught him whatever he liked. ولولا دفع الله الناس بعضهم ببعض. And had it not been that Allah Ta'ala has been removing one people by another, had it not been so, لَفَسَدَتِ الْأَرْضِ, the whole of the earth would have corrupted. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ, but Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is bountiful to the worlds.